Welcome to the RetroRemakes project in Unity. In this first video, I will give you a quick introduction what's part of the package. When you import and open the package in Unity and also open the game selection scene from the scenes folder, you will come to this menu, and when you start the project, you will see you have three games you can choose from. We'll take a look at each of them. First, it's Roller Maze. Please note that each of these games are designed with a different aspect ratio, so you have to set that accordingly from the drop-down. You can find the right aspect ratio for each game in the documentation. Roller Maze is about you having to control a ball and steering it with your mouse or keyboard keys through a labyrinth of pits and perils and find the exit. You can pick up coins or diamonds or keys. You can buy items that may help you. And of course, you have to avoid all traps and don't die. You have several floor types, like ice where you slide around and arrows that push you in one direction. You have doors you can unlock. And you have teleporters. And you have ramps and floor tiles that crack when you roll over them, so you have to be really careful. And for the fun, you can ride these tubes. This will bring us back to the beginning. And with the key we picked up on our way, we can open this door and go into the exit. After that, you can see if you have made a new high score for that level. And if you press a mouse button to continue, you will see the next level. Using Shift Escape, you will be brought back to the game selection menu. Next game we will look at is Lemurs. That has the aspect ratio of 640 by 480. And the goal of this game is to guide a bunch of lemurs, which are stumbling helplessly through the level if you don't help them. You can pause the game and look around to find the exit. This is here. And they have to find it and you have to help them. And they might fall down and die if you don't do that. So the first thing would be to stop them. And yeah, that was too late for him. We can assign a flower to him where he can glide down with. And you have other assignments as well. You can give one a shovel, for example, and he starts shoveling down. Oh, one is escaped. We give him a parachute thingy quickly. Yeah, that's your goal. Use your commands wisely to tell them what to do and help them not to kill themselves. Again, Shift Escape will bring you back to the main menu. The third game is Oil Tycoon. That's a management simulation game. This genre was very popular in the 90s, at least in Germany, and it's a purely UI-based game. We can set up the number of players. Four players are allowed. If you want to play alone, the other players are played by the computer. And of course, we can give us a name. We can then choose the oil company we want to work for and choose us a nice office where we conduct our business from. We can also choose winning conditions from here. For example, be the best player after 5 years. Okay, and after the summary screen, the game will start. From here, you have several options what you can do. For example, you can start buying land and drill for oil. You will get a map and select a region. And you have to buy a concession for each region before you can buy land. Then you can buy that plot of land and you will be asked if you want to drill for oil here immediately. And you can give the task to a specialist for a hefty price, or you can drill on your own, which will lead you to a nice mini game. You have to drill through several layers of earth with different firmness, and this one is really firm and you have to watch out, like I did not. You have to keep the cursor in the middle of the scanner here, so the drill has no great deviation of its path and breaks. So no luck today, but you can keep on trying until you get your oil. You can then buy tanks and sell the oil. You can also get expertises for the different sectors, or you can look up a few statistics, how much money each player has, or the development of the oil price over time. You can also interact with your fellow players in a not so nice way. For example, you can hire an agent and sabotage one of your competitors. For example, steal a bit of his money. Yeah. And you can see your possessions, how much maintenance costs you have per month, and so on. There's also a save and load functionality in this game, which is worth checking out, and a lot of options you can explore. When a month is over, the turn is ended and the other player can make his moves. If you want to end a month prematurely, you can just click on the calendar and end the turn. After that, the computer players will take their actions, and you will get a display of how much money each player has. And there is also a ticker running through, and that will inform you about the activities each player has taken last round. If you have studied the screen long enough, you can click your mouse and return to the office and start the next month. Again, Shift-Escape brings you back to the game selection menu, and that's it for the first overview. I hope you find it interesting. Good luck with playing all the games. And the next videos, we will take a closer look at each game, especially how they are structured, how the scenes are built, and how the game flow works. Hope to see you soon. Take care. Bye.